This video is about the standard operating procedure of AMST molecular vapor deposition system, MVD100. The MVD100 is an automated system that can deposit a few nanometer thin films, single molecular layer by layer, in order to modify the surface properties of devices. In our facility at UC Irvine, the MVD100 system is used to deposit FDTS, a fluorinated silane, onto the substrates in order to make the substrates extremely hydrophobic. By doing so, it allows the easy separation of the pattern molds from polymers after nanoimprinting. We will give you the introduction of nanoimprinter in a different video. So this is a login computer. Before we log into this computer, we should read the log sheets first to check the base pressure, the flow rate. If there's no issues from the former user, we can then log into this computer. Now we log in. After logging, we then go to the chest room. So this is the chest room. Before we go inside, we should always remember that the chest room is for supporting equipment and chemical gases. The supporting equipment are usually noisy and use high voltage, and the chemical gases are flammable and hazardous. So before we go inside, we should be very careful and we should smell and look first. If you see some suspicious liquid on the floor or smell strange odor, please don't go inside and immediately inform the lab manager or staff. For general users, we will first check the dryer pump is working, check the chiller is on, and the circulating pressure is pointing to the marked line. If everything's fine, we'll counterclockwise open the valve of the oxygen tank. After we come back from the chest room, we log into the system by touching this blue button. Enter your password. After logging, now we are on the page of main menu. For the general users, we will use view system, chamber routine, process sequences, and temperature control. Before we start, we'll view system first. We see that the system is under idle mode and the chamber is under vacuum. So everything is fine, so we need to write down the information of base pressure of the chamber here on the log sheet. And then we push main menu, come back. Now we need to set up the temperatures for two supplies. One is water, the second is FDTS. So here we need to turn on the line 3 supply by touching this toggle button, and now it's on. We also need to turn on the line 1 and line 3. And then we'll wait 5 to 10 minutes to wait till the temperature meets the preset temperature. Now the temperatures has reached the preset ones. And you can feel the chamber is slightly warmer than the room temperature. So the next step is to load the sample into the chamber. So we touch main menu and touch chamber routines. Before we vent the chamber, we need to purge the chamber first. Now you see the nitrogen comes in and is pumped out. And the water comes in again and pumped out again. By doing these 5 cycles, the purge process is completed. When the system is at the idle mode, we go back to the routines and vent the chamber. And the nitrogen will come in again to vent to the chamber. We have to wait a little bit until we hear the hissing sound here. So we hear the hissing sound. Now we can open the lid to load the chamber. Before we doing that, we need to get a piece of clean room wipe and spray a little bit of isoprenol. Clean up the chamber and the edge of the chamber. We put this waste into the flammable container. So before you load the sample, make sure you put on the mask to avoid contaminating the sample. So you put the sample into the center of the chamber and then close the lid. Then pump down the chamber by touching this. You see, first you will see the slow ISO valve is open and then closed. And then the ISO valve is open. By doing so, the sample in the chamber won't move. Now we load the sample. The system is at the idle mode. The next step is to run the sequence. So we go to the main menu, touch the process sequences, touch this orange button to load the recipes. Touch load, pick a recipe, and say yes. And then the recipe is loaded. Then we go back to the sequences and push the green button. So the recipe we loaded is a 6-layer recipe. It will take about 4 hours to finish it. So the process is about like this. First, the O2 plasma will treat the surface. And after that, by doing this, the precursor can bond to the sample. So then after the O2 plasma is done, then the water vapor will be injected for about 2 minutes. Then the precursors will be injected into the chamber for 30 minutes. Each cycle will be about 35 minutes. So the 6 cycles will take about roughly 4 hours. So during that time, you write down the information of the IF power and also the temperatures for the line 1 and the line 3. And the chamber temperature. And also write down how many reaction cycles and the time for each cycle. And also the flow rate of the oxygen. So it's 150, 152. So after 4 hours, we come back to unload the sample. Now after 4 hours, the process is done. The system is at the idle mode. So we can unload the sample by touching routines button. Same thing, touch purge first. It will take about 1 to 2 minutes. Now the purge step is done. We push routines again and vent the chamber. And the nitrogen comes in, we will hear the hissing sound again. Okay, we hear the hissing sound. And put the sample into the container. We close the lid. And touch routines. And pump down the chamber. Now the chamber is pumped down. The next step is to turn off the temperatures. So here we go back to the main menu and touch the temperature control. chain of line 3 supply, line 1, and the line 3. Now the temperatures are turned off, except the chamber temperature. Then we go back to main menu. And then we go to log out. Then we log out. So after you log out, you go to the chase room, turn the oxygen valve clockwise to close it.